What's up, YouTube? I'm Mike, and today I'm talking about how TRT can be, potentially, for some people, a very slippery slope. One of the number one performing videos on this channel is, I think, the first video I shot, which was titled TRT, How TRT Saved My Life, I think. I'll put a card up here so you can look at that video if you haven't already. That video brings a lot of people to this channel, a lot of guys who are considering getting on TRT, or that video gets promoted a lot, and one of the strange things that I get a lot in either comments or direct messages to me are guys talking about how in the video I described that going on testosterone replacement therapy solved a lot of my personal issues that I was treating with psych meds prior to finding out that my testosterone was on the low end of normal. And so I get all kinds of messages from guys reporting like all these different crazy conditions and like, hey, do you think TRT would help for me? And again, I always try to steer clear of giving anybody medical advice because I'm not a doctor and I don't want to make any definitive statements. Like, hormones are not something to be played around with. I've got lots of videos on this channel about what can happen if you screw with your estrogen levels. And so some really catastrophic things can happen to you personally when you play games with your hormones. And so I don't want to be, you know, anything to do with that. I'm not trying to promote anything. I'm just really sharing my personal experiences. And then people ask for advice and it kind of puts me in this weird position. So one of the things that I also wanted to talk about, because I want to be transparent, when people are using advice that you're giving or they're using your experiences to potentially make major decisions in their life, I feel like it's kind of time to talk about some of the long-term effects that I've experienced from having started TRT. And when I say long-term effects, I don't really mean like side effects or body effects. What I'm talking about is that I happen to be a person with a highly addictive personality. I've done like most all of the drugs you can do, not all of them, but I've definitely had problems with drugs in the past, and I just have a really addictive personality. And so one of my concerns is that testosterone replacement therapy, and I hate to use this term because I really hate it, but could be a gateway to steroid abuse. And so I want to talk about some of those things today just so people who are possibly watching that first video can come to this video and see some of the things that you could expect. So, when I first started on TRT, I was very nervous because of a couple of factors. One, I knew I was going to have to be injecting myself, and I had never used needles of any kind at all, period. Fucking terrified of needles. Anytime I would see a needle like anywhere in public, it just made my skin crawl. Very, very uncomfortable with needles. And so that was a major limiting factor. It's also one of the biggest reasons that I had never experimented with steroids in the past, because I didn't want to have to deal with needles. And then there's obviously the fear that the media bullshit stirs up. Like, they convince you that testosterone is this horribly evil thing, and anybody who takes testosterone or anybody who takes steroids is just gonna like go completely insane and lose their mind, and it's gonna destroy their hearts and it's gonna destroy their livers. And they so massively exaggerate the effects of testosterone and anabolic steroids that it can make you very wary of ever even using something that's doctor prescribed. And so those can be limiting factors to ever using steroids. So then in my case, for example, I go onto the TRT protocol and I get my kit in the mail, and it's got all these different needles and syringes, and all of a sudden you're thrust into this world that you never imagined you would be in. You know, you're like a little chemist in there, you're reconstituting your HCG and taking bacteriostatic water and adding it to this vial, and then you're drawing up all your injections and you're dosing everything out. And if you play with your protocol like I did, then you're kind of deviating from the program. And so you're injecting yourself a lot. You know, like, I inject my testosterone replacement twice a week using one needle, and then I have HCG twice a week using a different needle. So you've got intramuscular injections in various places of the body if you spread your injections around. You're going subcutaneously with HCG, and before you know it, you start to become very comfortable with needles. So my wife does the majority of my injections. And I remember asking her in the bathroom one day while I'm like bent over the counter and she's sticking a needle in my butt, like I'm kind of looking at her like, did you ever imagine that this is what you were gonna be doing when you were 40 years old, like stabbing your husband in the ass with a needle? It changes, it has changes in your household. My kids are now somewhat exposed to this. They know what's going on. They've seen the needles, you know? And so it can really change the dynamic in a home when you introduce something like this in it. Then there's the stigmas that come with it. So some people just associate testosterone with steroids, and then, you know, is my dad doing steroids? Is my dad doing testosterone replacement therapy? Like, there are a lot of factors to consider when you go down this path. For me, one of the things was I very rapidly got comfortable with the needles, and I very rapidly realized that all of the bullshit that the media feeds, like, they have you convinced that you inject yourself with a steroid and you're just gonna be the Incredible Hulk overnight. You're just gonna be ripping your clothes off, you're just gonna be beating everybody's ass that you come into contact with, you're just totally gonna lose your mind, you're gonna have roid rage, you're gonna have all of these problems. And they scare you with this data, and then you inject your testosterone and nothing happens. Like, you don't feel anything for weeks sometimes. You know, my dose is 200 milligrams. And another thing I want to talk about, I get guys in the comment section all the time, 200 milligrams is not a replacement dose. That's what's legal in my country. Call it hormone optimization if you want. But when you make a blanket statement like that, like 200 milligrams is not replacement, you're really talking out of your ass. Like, the design is to keep a person's hormone levels at the high end of normal for the majority of the week. In order to do that, you're going to have peaks that are super physiological. Now, admittedly, my levels peak much higher than the reference range using my dose. But my blood, all of my biomarkers are totally in line. So I like to think of it as hormone optimization therapy. I can get more gains, more well-being, more self-esteem, better performance in the gym, using a dose that makes me relatively super physiological, that is legal in my country, and has no negative side effects. I experienced zero negative side effects from a TRT dose only, 200 milligrams a week. So if you feel like that's a blast, then believe that all you want, but no one is becoming Arnold Schwarzenegger or Jay Cutler or Ronnie Coleman or any of these guys in 200 milligrams a week. I hate to break it to you. If that's what you think is going to happen, it's not. So regardless of all that, you become very comfortable with the needles. You find out that the hormones are not going to turn you into a raving lunatic that is just raping and pillaging. And so it makes you wonder, well, what would 500 milligrams do? If you're a person like me, it makes you curious because you go to the gym, you get these results, you put on a bunch of muscle, you cut body fat, you have strength gains, you have all these performance gains, and then after a period of time, that plateaus. And you miss it. And you want to get bigger. And you want to get stronger. You want to set that next PR. You want to bump things to the next level. And so in my case, I'm hoarding TRT to work up to a 500 milligram dose that I can run for, I think it was 14 weeks. I made a video on that, what you can expect from a 500 milligram a week dose of testosterone. And so next thing you know, now I'm doing a full blast. Now I'm blasting 500 milligrams of testosterone from a starting point of a guy who was scared of needles. And so you take 500 milligrams of test, and guess what? Nothing catastrophic happens. My blood pressure was fine. All of my biomarkers were fine. My strength went up again. I gained more muscle in the gym. I had more sexual appetite. Effectively, everything was good. Nothing was bad. And you go, what about more? And so this is the slippery slope that I'm talking about. There's a lot of data out there. Derek just did a video talking about a famous study where they gave guys multiple doses of testosterone, starting, I think, at 25 milligrams, going all the way up to 600 milligrams a week. They ran this for 20 weeks, and every one of the participants well tolerated even the highest dose of 600 milligrams a week. It was the most effective dose. They looked at all of their biomarkers, and everything was fine. So we have good scientific data that doses as high as 600 milligrams per week are well tolerated by study participants, and it makes you curious. So in my case, I was able to get a hold of Anavar legally from a doctor. Now we're throwing that in the mix. Now we've got high levels of testosterone. We've got an orally activated 17-alpha-alkylated oxandrolone dose. And so again, down the slippery slope we go, because we've gone from place of total alienation from this product or from this substance, fear of this substance perpetuated by overblown fears in the media. You find out that the fears are unreasonable. You find out that the dosing protocol is easy to manage, and it can lead you into a potentially dangerous addiction. And that's where you see these guys that unfortunately die. John Meadows recently passed away. You've got all of the examples, you know, the rich pianas who work their way up to insanely high doses of hormones, push their body weight to extreme levels. You know, Rich Piana famously talked about how he could just sort of tell that his body did not want to be 300 pounds. It was just constantly fighting him. There was no part of his body that wanted to be that big, whether it was 300 pounds of muscle or 300 pounds of fat. This is an unnatural state for the body, and the body weight alone is probably more damaging to your health than the drugs that are used to get there. So, all of this has just been said because I want to be totally transparent for anyone who's coming to my channel, looking at that original video, thinking that TRT is going to solve all your problems in life. One, it's not. Okay, guys? It's not going to solve all your problems. Like, my life was markedly better across the board using TRT. I do believe that optimizing your hormones is a really valuable way of making sure that you have the best chance at living a productive life. But you still have to do the rest of the work. You still have to maintain proper diets. You still have to be a healthy person psychologically. Testosterone replacement therapy is not going to remove you of your delusions. It's not going to remove you. It's not going to eradicate mental diseases or mental disorders. You have to understand there are limitations to what this can do. It is not a miracle drug. It is designed to put your body back into a natural state so that you have all of your ducks in a row, and then you can work on your mental health. Then you can work on relationships with your spouse or with your employer or with your children. It's very hard to work on those parts of your life when your hormones are all out of whack. But please don't misunderstand, this is not a miracle cure. You still have to do the extra work. And if you have an addictive personality, if you are already into bodybuilding, if you are coming to TRT because you want performance-enhancing gains, please just be aware of the fact that it could very easily lead to the abuse of steroids that is going to suck you into an underground world that can be seedy and dangerous and potentially devastating to your health. So, I hope you guys got something out of this. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below. Follow me on Instagram for more of my daily lunacy. And as always, we'll see you on the next one.